Hi everyone, I'm Sam Bettens. It is 100 degrees in Palm Desert, California, and today's topics include using the men's bathroom, my first Father's Day, boy versus man, and the wonderful Gillette commercial. But first, this.
I just came out of the courthouse in Palm Springs and filed my papers for name and gender change. And it was a little bit of a non-event, I guess. It was smooth and easy, but I still feel like I have to go celebrate. I guess it'll take 6 weeks or maybe even a little longer for everything to be done. But it's filed, it's happening, it seems like it's getting official, and I'm really happy. I feel great. It's a milestone.
That happened. All these little steps, they add up and they inch me closer to my true self, the person in between my ears. And that person is slowly starting to recognize himself with every day that passes. So the men's room. If you're a cisgender man, you don't know any better. You don't have the history, like I do, of having had the pleasure of using the ladies' room. So you're blissfully unaware that there's a whole world out there without smelly urinals. I'm sorry to say you're missing out. It's not exactly like walking into a fancy spa, but generally speaking, the ladies' room is a lot cleaner. That being said, I never felt quite at home there. I used to come up with all these tricks to make sure other ladies didn't think I was an intruder. I'd stick my chest out, I would be talking on the phone so people could hear my voice, or walk in with a friend to look less threatening. Basically, walking into a ladies' public restroom has been a royal pain in the ass for me for my entire life. I wasn't confrontational enough to say, like, what, you've never seen a lesbian before, and make the other person feel bad. So I would just keep my head down and pretty much hope no one else was in the bathroom. The first time I tested out a men's bathroom was in the Delta lounge at the airport. I was a little nervous. I had my arms over my chest, looking down, waiting for a stall to open. And then I realized, for the first time in my life, no one was looking at me. For the first time in my life, no one was telling me to go use another restroom. I fit right in. It was revelational. I was still questioning when I did this, and it was such a moment, I'll never forget it. The next time I tried it was on a road trip to Yosemite with my wife. We stopped at a gas station and she said, go on, big shot, try the men's room. So I walked in and quickly realized I was no longer at the Delta Airlines lounge. As soon as I opened the door, a smell that can only come from a man's poop came over me, and I saw two black working boots stick out from underneath the one and only stall. This was a test, and I failed. I wasn't transitioning yet, I was still Sarah, so I quietly slipped out and went into the ladies' room, which, by the way, wasn't that much better. But that was the last time. I feel quite at home in the men's room now, stink and all.
Happy Father's Day. The words sounded like music to my ears. If you're wondering, it still sounds strange, even to me. But it felt good hearing those words coming out of my kids' mouths the morning of. They have been amazing. They don't second guess. They made the switch and they've moved on to their 8-year-old daily life, like basketball camps and hoverboards. It felt good to get messages and a few cards from friends acknowledging this was my first one. Probably my favorite part was opening the package from my father-in-law, who passed on his electric razor, like his dad did to him, with a few notes of advice. It was such an uninhibited display of acceptance. It made me quiet for a second. I didn't need to go play golf or get a brand new toolbox, although both ideas are not bad for my birthday coming up in September. I just enjoyed the reality of another step in the right direction. At the same time, a lot of people didn't even think about wishing me a happy Father's Day. Not because they don't think I deserve it, just because it didn't even occur to them. My 23-year-old daughter has thought of me as her stepmom since she was 6 years old. It didn't even register for her that I would be part of Father's Day now. I'm not trying to throw her under the bus. I know she felt bad after. I'm just saying it out loud so I can point out that it's totally normal. These things just take time. By the way, she had a test the day after and aced it, so all is forgiven anyway. I've said it before, I'm very lucky. And if you don't feel so lucky, I hope time will do its job for you and for the people around you. The other day, my oldest son ran into one of my firefighter buddies back in Johnson City, Tennessee, and he said, hey, say hello to your mom and stepmom, I mean stepdad. I'm telling you, if a Johnson City firefighter can get on board with trans, so can the rest of the world. We'll get there, people. We shall get there. I love being a dad and a stepdad. It just fits. I loved being a mom and a stepmom too, but I always felt more like a dad than a mom. My kids have a mom, a great mom, a stay-at-home mom, who goes to the library twice a week to get new books, who makes sure we all sit around the dinner table at night with a hot meal, and who rubs our kids' bellies when they're sick. I loved being a bonus parent with my stepkids, throwing the ball, playing board games, roughhousing, shopping, being their number one fan at all their games and events, reading to them, camping, trying to make them laugh, and I love parenting the new batch of 8-year-olds. I don't want to stereotype and differentiate between the role of a mom and a dad. We're all parents, and we can all be great at everything that parenting entails. It just sounds right to me that I'm a dad now. See? This proves it. And speaking of fathers and their sons, I don't know if you guys have seen the new Gillette commercial, but it's making me never want to use another razor again. It's basically a transgender son being shown by his father how to use a razor. And if that shit doesn't move you, you're cold as ice. I don't think you can underestimate the role the media plays in advancing people's minds when it comes to things like transgender. Here's this transgender kid who looks handsome and friendly and nice, and his dad who looks like the center of normal, and just like that, all these people that think they've never seen a transgender man before have seen a transgender man. And it wasn't as scary as they thought it was gonna be. And actually, he's kinda cute. I would never wanna tell another person when they should come out trans or gay. But every time someone does, especially on a big stage like that, the world takes a huge step forward. And when a giant company like Gillette, supposedly the best a man can get, is not only on board, but a full-on ally to the trans community, well, that's when the queer gods look down upon us and say, well done, people. Well done. And here's some food for thought. For me, and maybe for you as well, man versus boy. While I was questioning my gender, I noticed I was using the word boy a lot instead of man. Wish I was a boy, wish I could go through life as a boy, wish I could jump in a pool with board shorts and nothing else like a boy. Let's face it, I'm 46, there's not much boy about it. I wonder if I kept using boy more than man, because I feel like I missed out on a part of my life. I never got to be a boy at 16. I never got to play on my brother's soccer team. I probably wasn't good enough, but that's beside the point. I never got to live life in a young man's body. So possibly this is just one of those things that I'll need to mourn and come to terms with. All part of the process, I guess. Maybe I'll feel more like a man when I start sounding and looking like one more than I do now. I'll keep you posted. That's what this vlog is for. This is what I love about documenting my transition in real time. 6 months from now, I may feel differently about a lot of these things. And if I don't write it down or put it in these vlogs, I'll forget the process. And life is all about the process, how you get to where you're going, not the final destination. Well, vlogging is a blast, but I'm a musician and I need to go do musician things. Case Choice has another show, Rex Rebel has a studio day coming up, and Sam wants to be a bass player, so I gotta get cracking. Hope you're enjoying the beginning of summer, everyone. I love you. I appreciate you. Hang loose.